So, why would I want smart splitters? Well, let's look at this example. At the moment, what we have is this little system right here, which is going along doing its little task as it should be. Now, if I say foundation, and hopefully, yep, we can make it. Right, so up here, what we can do is this, if we go, just for now, yoink, and yoink, and yoink, everything comes to a starting stop. And then we get rid of that, because, like, we're meanies. That was the floor. Don't get rid of the floor by accident. That's a bad idea. So, we go logistics and we get a Mark 1 conveyor. And we point them all onto that ledge above. This gives me a point of reference to be able to set up my smart splitters. Not because they need to be higher. So, better. So, we now have their inputs coming up here. So what we then do is we go to our ore logistics, we go down. Smart splitter, yep, should be able to at least make 3. So we set it going in that direction. Are you there? And then we go plus and plus. Right, so we have 3 smart splitters, and what we do is we tell on the center one anything that overflows. Sounds strange, but trust me. Now, we're not going to be using the left output because that's against the wall. So this one, the right output, we scroll down and we tell it ore. So now, only ore will be set anything. Anything else is going to get passed on to the next splitter. So this splitter, we tell it to put the ingot. Then we join that with this one, and we go, hey you, this right output, please put, where is Q quickwire? So what this will do is it'll keep on feeding stuff down here until it gets to here. Once all that is filled up, it will pass whatever's going that direction down the line. And why would that be a good idea? It's actually very simple. I think I jumped the gun a bit. Can I get a... No, I can't. I do need to add a bit at the end. Not much of a bit. And probably the same goes for you. And those both need to be Mark IIs. For the belt system, this system to work, it's best if you use the next markup of whatever you're using as standard. Like at the moment, my standard is 60. I only use 120 when I can. Or if I, well, if I really desperately need to. So, we'll get rid of you. And we put an entrance into this system, which is just going to be there. Actually, we don't have to have it low down, do we? We can have it like that. So we've still got a floor. So, what do we do next? I'll take that away. And you... need to go into a merger. Which is going my way. So let's get rid of you, let's get rid of you. Nope, that's too fine. Ow, that was me eating something. I didn't mean to. Okay, you are... Oh, that's me accidentally eating something again. Merger, let's try and avoid that clearance issue again. Invalid shape, okay, so... let's get you... Merger. That'll solve the problem. Then... Oh, you're kidding me. It's not one thing, it's another. Ooh, actually, it's not too much of a biggie. We can work around that. Okay. Then we add another merger. Da da. This is all ugly for now. Okay, you are going to need to be on the floor. So conveyor lift Mark II. That. And that. So that's the quick wire going. And then, doink, doink. And now we're getting a mix of things going up. If I... This is just for the sample process. And you see how it's splitting these up at the moment. At the moment, it's working fine because none of these things are full. If there is congestion, though, it will pass on. That's how come we've got a bit of caterum at the end. So what we do then is for situations like that. Get this. Come down. Get a conveyor belt. And tie it into this track that I laid earlier. Very Blue Peter of me. Which comes back round here. Have I overtaken it? Nope. Comes round here into this container, which then goes on a Mark 1 into our recycler. So as these things get full, I will keep producing them, but they will, instead of just being backed up on the line, they will automatically go in for recycling, which gets me more points, which gets me more vouchers, which gets me more of those other things that I want from the shop. It also opens up the entire idea of automating sorting, like that entire system. At the end of the day, I'm going to be aiming to have all of my items around here being auto-sorted. So when I unlock a train, it can be going to somewhere else and it can just dock into the system, do a quick sort of type, and then dump it into different sections of the base, which will then automatically sort it, and if I've got too much, it'll automatically get recycled. It's a beautiful system. This is why I said this is all temporary, for the simple reason that, again, all this can be reduced down to one belt that sort of goes here, comes along here, and then you can actually tie it in to this system, which is beautiful. But that's the catch. You have to have good belts. For small situations like this, it's fantastic. As you scale up, you do need the faster belts to be able to cope with the bandwidth. The test case that I've got running on my private save, they're running Mark 5s. And damn, yeah, it's definitely needed for processing the quantity that gets dumped into the system. So, where are we? You are pretty much at... that's tempting. I could, I suppose, just out of sheer principle. Got it. Terium. Go. So we're going to be having power poles Mark 2. Go back here. We have a look. Hypertubes is a method of high-speed transportation. Stackable hypertube. Vehicular transport. That would be tempting. And then here we have jump pads. So I'm quite happy letting things just produce by itself. What are you making? You are making modular frames, which I'm now using. And you, are making reinforced plate. Sweet. Okay, which we need because future expansion and all of that jazz. Perfect. We are ahead of schedule, which is frightening. Yeah, long way off. But yeah, you kind of end up having an overflow track Is any one of these close to capping off, out of curiosity? Your start to cap off, and the ingots might, because they're both 100 items. We can actually drop that in, and we can actually drop that in. Do a quick sort. I need some concrete for myself. Okie doke. So, concrete, iron rods. AI limiters, but yes, I mean, this entire mess back here, I could just lay a really high speed track for screws and basically have it all end at this screw section. And then once that's full, I could tell it to send excess over. So a lot of these screwy ones that you see dotted about, I wouldn't have to worry about, which would be nice. But, and how's this going along? Twenties. How many steel beams do you use? You use 30, and I think I produce 30. Fifteen. Okay, that'll be why. It could be worth just temporarily. How many do you need? 60. Yeah, that's the problem, isn't it? Okay. We'll have a think about that in the meantime. Let's have a bit of an getting wire over here. It's probably that'd be why. It's trying to filter, but I don't mind. It'll still get filled. How are you? 29 seconds, so we have you, Telegun, Mycilla, and Biomass, which we have both of. That makes a lot of sense to me. So let's research you. So, fabric. And that's a parachute. Okay. Satan, no. Power splugs. No quartz. We need a bucket load. And we need the other stuff. Okay, so probably going to be the best plan. It's night at the moment. Wow, subtle. Oh, poor thing. So we have. Nope, not that. Yes, yes, yes. How are they? as our new hole. A little bit more expensive, but it looks like, yeah, the only real change is over to quick wire, which isn't too bad. Organization, foundations. So yes, I think I'm just gonna let things run for now until it gets to daytime. And then I'm gonna go on and explore. Let's see how many we're at. 60. That's not too shabby. Wow, they look cool. But yes, so it's gonna be fun with the smart splitters. Half tempted to rip all this up and just, oh no. How are you doing? Good. So you're gonna be the entry to the system. Probably means if I put a foundation here for now. And add a foundation there. So right about here, we would need a merger. And I did. Okay, you two are practically married. Yep. Okay, so one's going that way, which we're okay with. Let's think about this. Front. What could be a good idea is actually putting my mergers along here. Right, if we had our first merger, let's say on this corner. Okay, so we need some more plates. Grabbing more plates. Da 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 da. So we come across here. Whoa, crap. I gotta get used to that newfangled air control. Do 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 do. You are empty. Perfect. Smart splitter. Coming in that direction. So again, we set this to overflow. This is, like I say, the quick and the dirty way of doing it. We set this one on the right output to cold. This one, even though we're not producing it yet, we put this to steel ingot. And this one, we put to steel pipe. then we mark to it between. We do that, we do that, and we do that. Right, we will need one more smart splitter. What's the gappage? Yep, that is the gappage. And then we need another one. Yep, perfect. See, I am building future proofing into the system, which is epic. Boink and boink, boink and boink, boink and boink. Which gets us to here. At which point I then need to decide how I'm going to handle this situation. Honestly, there's a couple of ways I could tackle this. I could come straight out of that, extend up into a merger with a feeder coming round in, which kind of seems like the best idea at the moment. Only catch with that is going to be I won't be able to put a floor down. The other way is to bring that down. Okay. Blink, blink. So you are there. On that lip, no. Okay. So we put a merger. Let's get rid of that. Let's get rid of that. And put that in there. Go there. Then we get rid of that. Make it look all neaty. And we have a suspended thingamajig. That like that. And that's going in. So rank 2, so rank 2, so all that's left to do to get this system operational again is drop that in. Let's get rid of that pole, and now that is all going over there. Then what we do, just here, set up another merger, and this one, because it's high priority, we do that with, get you, and route you into there, And we have all that going into this sorting system now. And we get rid of that. And that. Okay. Need to get up there fairly sharpish. Yep, that's why. Boing. Boing. Wait. Air control. Okay. And you overflow right est. Steel beam. There we go. I already know what you're gonna be for, so we put overflow. And we put beam. Encased industrial beam. You, we're gonna leave free for now and just overflow. And bingo, we have an automated system. And doesn't it look cool? We get rid of you. Get rid of you. You. Get rid of you. Up we go. Don't need you anymore. Perfect. Don't need you anymore. Don't need you anymore. See, now it kind of looks like that's being supported by that lift, which is nice. Let's have a look up here. Yep. Nothing's backed up too much yet. So it's all moving smoothly, which is nice. Loads of ore coming this way. All getting subdivided. But yes, this is the best way that I found to set up one of these things. Ooh. Oh no, it is making it there. It's just that gap makes you think it won't make it. Is start at the end of the chain. And then build it through. So obviously I've just integrated the steel section into my grand master plan, which is nice. How are these doing? Getting that right. Sulfur. Now I've gone in most directions. I just haven't gone in that direction. So let's have a look, shall we? Anything over here? No. Okay. Catch. So I see metal. What's protecting you? Oh, them things. I hate those things. They're too quick. Actually, I hate any monster in this game. Where's the Ford? Okay, which, okay, let's put the light brigade. No, that didn't work. Okay. Circuit board, neat. Heatsink, neat. Circuit board. Screws. Need anything? 30 watts. Okay. I think we can do that. Too long. That's the boundary. Okay.
Hard drive has been salvaged and can be repurposed to unlock an alternate recipe. Salvaging more hard drives will provide additional alternate recipes.
Okay. So that's something to keep an eye out for. More of those. Come on, give me some sulfur. That looks incredibly enticing. Slug. What's the catch? It's gotta be a catch, right? I just wouldn't do. There's the catch. That's why I like this thing. Oh, you pooped it out your butt. Okay. And floating nut thing. Okay. Metal. What's guarding it though? Okay, it's not that. Because that's cute and fluffy. Oh, it's you guys. For England! Things. Generally, I hate anything that attacks me. I think that's the general rule of thumb at the moment. Anything over here? No. Ooh, fire. It needs rotors. Okay. I can go back for some rotors. We have plenty. This isn't helping my sulfur situation. Oh, I could probably drop the hard drive in as well. And let's have some of my nuts. There's base. Oh yeah, that's getting like a distinct footprint on the landscape now. getting to the point. Well, no, because I haven't been away for long enough. That's in here. Hard drive. 10 minutes. Okay. There was another one that needed the scanny slot for. In here, let's put that. I don't need those. The other things are probably handy. I need routers. Okay, I just gone past the routers. And we're off again. Da 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 da. Okay. I'll get that slug on the way back. That's a plan. So there's crash site one. And more wreckage up there. No. They look fairly normal, rocky type things. Oh man, I'm gonna be on the hunt for wreckages now, aren't I? Wreckages, wrecks. Slug on there. How do roaches fix this? I mean, seriously. A cacti thing. Okay. Strange you just being there. In the middle of nowhere. We iron? We're normally guarded. Two. You. Iron pure. Another one. Iron pure. Iron pure. So that's 1, 2, 3. Have I got any beacons? I have one. Three times iron. Thank you. So iron alloy ingot. Fine concrete. Charcoal. Interesting. Okay, we have power slug. Oh no, we don't have to. It's just that. So let's do this then. That's another one going. Yes, I did. Yeah, sluggy, sluggy. Let's convert you into some power shards. Yep, power shards. Whatever that is. We need some coal. Now the evil plan starts to happen. Yep. And there you go. Are slowly going in now. How are you? It's not getting too backed up. That's good. What was I doing? Oh, yes. Black powder. We need 20 more. That's a pain in the rear, isn't it? You can go in there, you can go in there. We sort you. As you are now starting to get things. Two more coupons. Which is always good. Coupons in that. There, we'll take you out to be recycled. Put you in there, sort you. That's not needed. We have a home for that. Put the coal in. This one, I believe, yes. Sweet. And yeah, you're operating at about 50%. Surprise. Okay, that's that. So how many coupons am I up to? 4. Some portable miners, and we're gonna go after those. Probably be wise to make a beacon or two. Nope, we don't need two because I have one. Yes. that I don't want to lose. Don't want to lose that. Don't want to lose that. Everything else I'm kind of okay with. I'll drop you there. Got 100. How are you doing on versatile frames? Okay, this way, this way. Six, six. Okay. Slowly increasing. That's going to be a long-term project.